morning. Our entrance is number 471. 471. I have not seen, ear has not heard, what God has ready for those who love Him. Spirit of love, come give us the mind of Jesus. Teach us the wisdom of God.
Together in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
And with your spirit.
As we gather this day, we call to mind the times we have failed, the times we have sinned. So prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are the Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. May St. Dominic come to the help of your church by his merits and teaching, O Lord. And may he, who was an outstanding preacher of your truth, be a devoted intercessor on our behalf. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. When I came to you, brothers and sisters, proclaiming the mystery of God, I did not come with sublimity of words or of wisdom. For I resolved to know nothing while I was with you, except Jesus Christ and Him crucified. I came to you in weakness and fear and much trembling. And my message and my proclamation were not with persuasive words of wisdom, but with a demonstration of power, of spirit and power, so that your faith might rest not on human wisdom, but on the power of God. Yet we do speak of wisdom to those who are mature, but not a wisdom of this age, nor of the rulers of this age who are passing away. Rather, we speak God's wisdom, mysterious and hidden, which God predetermined before the ages for our glory, and which none of the rulers of this age knew. For if they had known it, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. But as it is written, what eye has not seen, and ear has not heard, and what has not entered the human heart, what God has prepared for those who love Him. This God has revealed to us through the Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Proclaim God's marvelous deeds to all the nations.
Proclaim God's marvelous deeds to all the nations.
Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all you lands. Sing to the Lord, bless his name.
Proclaim God's marvelous deeds to all the nations.
Announce his salvation day after day. Tell his glory among the nations. Among all peoples, his wondrous deeds.
Proclaim God's marvelous deeds to all the nations.
Give to the Lord, you families of nations. Give to the Lord glory and praise. Give to the Lord the glory due his name.
Proclaim God's marvelous deeds to all the nations.
Say among the nations, the Lord is King. He made the world firm, not to be moved. He governs the people with equity.
Proclaim God's marvelous deeds to all the nations.
If we think of the saint that we celebrate today, Saint Dominic, the founder of the order of preachers, or the Dominicans, if you will, if we think of him, every single one of those scriptures in the responsorial psalms certainly speak loudly to him. He trusted not in his own wisdom, but in the power of God to inform him what to do. And, as we know, he went about proclaiming the good news to all the nations, to all the people he could find. And he went about, meaning he had no place to rest his head. You know, when I read that line, I thought how oftentimes we might think that, oh, poor Jesus was homeless. No, that wasn't the case at all. Poor Jesus wasn't poor Jesus, but Jesus on the move. And so it wasn't about, you know, becoming sedentary, you know, just sitting there and doing nothing. He had a mission to accomplish, and he set about to do that mission. Also, when I think of St. Dominic, I think he brings together what I would call the Mary and Martha syndrome. You know, it's contemplation and action, not either or, but both and. You can't very well do something if you haven't thought about it beforehand, taken time to consider it. By the same token, you can't consider something without then acting on what you consider. That's who Dominic was, and that's who you and I are called to be. We're called to be people who are reflective. We're called to be people who are prayerful. We're called to be people who do take time to contemplate and not just shoot from the hip. But when we do act, act with the grace and the power and the wisdom of God. Let our prayer move us to action and be blessed by our God.
For the church and her leaders, may the Lord bless and uphold them in their labor for the kingdom of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For lawmakers, may God's grace direct their hearts in proposing laws that protect the life and rights of all people, including those yet unborn. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who feel despair, may God lift the cloud of darkness and fill them with his hope. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered here, may the Holy Spirit bestow upon us perseverance that we may grow in our discipleship. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, especially Georgianne Bain, Frederick Burkhart, Netta Carlson, Agnes Clark, Emma Colletti, Michael Curry, Mike Firth, Doug Fox, Jerry Molinak, Sister Lucia Madigan, Joanne Pustizzi, Brooke Russell, Carol Scaley, Louise Seichel, Jane Sharpneck, Ken Shoemaker, Andrew Stefanacci, Ron Tokar, John Mount Gutton, Bob Wakeman, Clara Whitus. For the victims and survivors of abuse in our church and beyond, for their accountability, justice, and healing throughout our church, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, marked with the sign of faith, may God's glory soon shine upon them. For those who have recently died, and for Dwight Strayer, for whom this Mass is being offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions that remain deep in the silence of our hearts and minds, for those written in our prayer notes book, and for those we have been asked to pray for through our renewal recommitment initiative, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, hear us this day, as we pray in the name of your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we get this bread to life. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Attend mercifully to the prayers we offer you, O Lord, by the intercession of Saint Dominic, and through the great power of this sacrifice, strengthened by the protection of your grace, those who champion in the faith. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right.
In our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of Saint Dominic, you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life. Teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Edward our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to each other the sign of peace.
Sins of
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
This is the steward, faithful and prudent, whom the Lord set over his household to give them their allowance of food at the proper time. May your church, O Lord, receive with wholehearted reverence the power of this heavenly sacrament, by which we have been nourished on the commemoration of Saint Dominic. And may your church, having flourished by means of his preaching, be helped through his intercession. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Our closing is number 471, verse 2. I have not seen, ear has not heard, what God has ready for those who love Him. Spirit of love, come give us the mind of Jesus. Teach us the wisdom of God. Our lives are but a single breath. We flower and we fade, yet our days are in your hands. So we return in love what love has made.